If you're looking to learn how to use particles inside of DaVinci Resolve, then this is the video for you because I'm going to teach you all of the tools and skills necessary to get started with using these things inside of Fusion. So without any further ado, let's get into this. Here we are inside of DaVinci Resolve. Now that we're here, we're gonna add a solid color into our timeline to act as our background. You can also use any kind of footage for this, but a solid color is what we're gonna be using today so that we can see it more easily. Now we're gonna go into our effects in our toolbox here, and we're gonna grab a fusion composition and pop that right on top of our colored background. We'll go ahead and click that, and then we're gonna jump into Fusion. Now that we're in Fusion, we have our media out. We're gonna add a background node so that we have something to feed into our media out. Now that we've done that, we're gonna add all three of these particle nodes over here. We have particle emitter, particle merge, and particle render. Now that we have all three of these nodes, we're gonna run them into one another. And now that we have all of these put together, we're gonna add in a merge node between our background and our media out, just a regular merge, and then we're gonna connect our particle renderer into that merge. And you'll see right away when we do that, we get some particles showing up in our media out window up here. So we'll go ahead and set this back to fit, and then we'll grab our particle emitter, and with this node, we can change the number of particles we have, the variance in the number of particles we have, so if you want different ones at different times and you want it to be kind of randomish. We have the lifespan, which is how long each individual particle lasts. We have lifespan variance, which is going to affect all of your particles differently so that the lifespan is a little bit different for each one, just so that it doesn't look so rigid if that's something that you're after. We have color, which will actually affect on the style page. We have position variance, which kind of makes them come from not exactly the same spot every time. Temporal distribution, so that if your emitter is moving, it will emit different numbers at different times, which can be very nice because, again, it helps it to look less static. We have velocity of the particles and direction that they're moving. So if you want your particles to move, we'll use velocity. If you want your particles to rotate, we'll use rotation. And if we want them to spin, we'll do that. And that's a 3D effect, so they'll spin this way instead of this way. Now that we have that, we'll get into our style menu here, which is this little paintbrush. We'll go ahead and click on that. We can change the shape of our particles. For this, we're just gonna be using point, but feel free to play around with any of these. N-gons are like polygons, any of these shapes up here, and you can change the number of sides they have, but we're sticking to point because it's simple and it's basic and it's easy to wrap your head around how to use it. Then we have color controls and fade controls. Both of those are pretty self-explanatory. So we will go ahead and move on to the region, and the region is going to change the shape and size and rotation of your actual particle emitter. So the region is like the shape of the emitter, and style affects the shape and color of the actual particles themselves. And between those three controls, you'll have everything that you need. So the first thing that we're going to do to make this effect look good is increase the number of points that we're using. So I'm gonna go ahead and hold control so that we don't change this too quickly, and then I'll drag this up a couple of times till we get to a point that looks like a somewhat dense, like something that could be a star trail. And then I'm going to move it down closer to where it's going to start from, because we're gonna have it arc up and then down out the other side. So we'll go ahead and leave the lifespan where it is, but we're gonna turn lifespan variance up quite a bit so that some of them fade away faster than other ones. We'll use the style color, that sounds good to me. Velocity, they don't need to be moving in any direction for this, they're just gonna be left behind, but if you need them to float up after or down or in any direction, this is where you'll get into your velocity controls and you can see which way they'll move. If you increase that velocity and then variance, you'll see that some of them go faster, others of them move a little slower. And then angle affects the direction that they're going to actually be moving in. Angle variance makes it so some of them go different directions. You get the idea. Now that all that is back to where it should be, which is completely reset, we're gonna go ahead and start to animate our thing right here. So in order to move this, we need our region controls because we don't want to affect the particles, we want to affect the emitter itself. So we get on over into our region settings right here. We're gonna leave that a sphere, we're gonna leave the size, and we're going to go ahead and keyframe the X and Y offset, and then we're gonna move it off the screen here. And then if we move forward to about the middle-ish of our footage, we're gonna move it up here. And then if we get to the end, or closer to the end, we're gonna go ahead and move that down here. You see, we have a pretty ugly looking line now. What we wanna do for that is get our spline editor, make sure that our X and Y offset are showing up, zoom out a little bit, grab all of these, right click on one of them, go ahead and smooth that, and you'll see that right there it gets a lot more smooth, and then right click it again, and we're gonna do ease out and ease in, and then we're gonna just increase those so that we get a more smooth line. And now, since this is off the other side, we can see where it's going to end up at the very end, and we'll get back into our particle controls. What we're gonna do here is increase that lifespan variance, and we're going to decrease that main lifespan until we can almost see some, but they're pretty much gone. So we'll watch this back at full speed here, at least full speed in Fusion. You see that it shoots up and then goes away, and as it moves, the trail fades behind it. So what we're gonna do now is take these, group them together with Control G, press F2 to rename them, and we're gonna name this Trail. We'll still be able to access all of those controls, but we're gonna need to double click on this to open the group, and then we'll need to access the controls from in there. Now we're just more organized. We know that this is the trail. Now what we're gonna do is come into our media pool, and we're gonna import a picture of, in this case, just a star. Now that we have our star, we're gonna go ahead and drag it on in here, and we are going to add this into a new merge node. And we want this to be on top, so we're going to add it later on in the process. And when we add this in right away, it's huge. So we need to click on this media in, give it a transform node, and go ahead and just shrink that down quite a bit. And now that our star is in there as well, we're going to go ahead and make sure that that is off screen for the beginning. And then we're going to find where our particle emitter hits the zenith of its curve, which is right here, this frame. It's right in the middle, right there. And we're going to go ahead and put our star now in that same spot, but a little bit ahead of it, because we want this to be coming out the back of the star. And then we're going to make sure that our center is keyframed, and our angle, we'll just turn it just a little bit, right? We don't want to turn in a ton, but some. Then we'll get back into our emitter, we'll find that last keyframe, and then we'll bring the star to that same spot over there, just like that. And then we'll turn it a little bit more just so it keeps that rotation going. And now we're going to turn angle off in here, and we're going to keep our center path displacement, and we're going to do the same thing to this that we did to our star trail. We're going to smooth it by right clicking it, and then we're going to add our in and out, which we have added already. So we're going to go ahead and increase those both a bit. And now if we watch this back, we have a star and the particles coming out of there. Looks like the star needs to end up a little higher, so we'll just boost that up. Should work the same way. Star needs to be higher in the middle as well. Actually, higher on the start. So now if we watch through this, we'll see that there is a trail of dust following our shooting star that we just added to this black background. So if we want to change the color of those, we'll go ahead and go into Style, Color Controls, and since it's a yellow star, why don't we just make them yellow particles? Now if we close this down and we go ahead and scrub through again, we'll have yellow particles following a yellow shooting star. It's that easy to get started using particles in DaVinci Resolve. Just play around with those controls. This tutorial should give you the tools to explore using the particles system inside of Fusion, and hopefully it's given you a little bit of confidence in your ability to actually make some effects. So please let me know in the comments down below what you're planning to do with these particle effects, and I will see you in tomorrow's episode of Fast Fridays.